Rhiannon in Welsh mythology was the daughter of Herod and the long-suffering wife of Pwyll, a chieftain of the Dyfed. All of Rhiannon's troubles stemmed from her rejection of Gwal, the man to whom she was promised, and as a result, his enraged father had laid a spell on Pwyll's household. Because of this spell, Rhiannon suffered years of barrenness, and after the birth of a son, she was unjustly accused of eating the baby. Yep. Eating the baby. Even after the boy who she named Predary, which meant care, had been restored and grown up, the spell continued to dog Rhiannon, and at one stage she and Predary were changed into donkeys. Yeah, donkeys. Rhiannon herself had her own magical aspect, however, for the singing of her birds was said to be able to wake the dead and send the living to sleep. Now, if you wake the dead, don't they become the living and then they have to go to sleep? Seems confusing. I don't know. Rhiannon is a singular figure in Welsh mythology. She bore her suffering and injustice with a patience that still seems remarkable. But her real nature was in all likelihood originally connected with horses. Yeah, did you see how he got from there to here? When Pwyll first set eyes on her, Rhiannon was riding a big, fine, pale white horse, covered with a garment of shining gold brocade silk. Also, Rhiannon's stolen son was found in a stable, and her punishment for losing him was to act like a beast of burden to visitors who came to her husband's palace. Yeah, how you doing? This is my wife. Let her carry your luggage. It is tempting to link her here with the horse goddess Epona, one of the few Celtic gods or goddesses to be worshipped by the Romans as well. Hey, thanks for watching Late Night Mythology. Check us out on the website. Click subscribe. That's that button right there. It's over there. Somewhere down there. And yeah, check us out. See what we're doing. We've got some other videos. Thanks.